T-minus 3 days until the barrel race that I spontaneously entered. Can you help us get in? Done something I have never done before. I entered a rodeo for this weekend. I have never competed in a rodeo ever in my life. I have not ever even taken a barrel racing lesson, but it is something that have been on my bucket list, so I'm going to give it a try. And here's a little clip of the horse that I'm hoping to try it on.
Y'all have seen Gus several times on our channel. He's our rescue pony, rescued from feral and neglect, and we've had him for just about a year. Tuesday's practice included a lot of trot and getting him not to dive so much into that first barrel and use more of his hind end.
It's T minus 3 days now. Yeah, 3 days until the barrel race that I spontaneously entered because it's always something I wanted to do. And Mr. Gus is about the only rescue that we've had in a while that's athletic enough and kind of naturally inclined enough to handle it. I rode him a little bit on Monday just to refresh his mind. Tuesday. And then I also rode him today, which is Wednesday. The rodeo's on Saturday.
Wednesday's practice, working on tightening up around that second barrel.
And he's a little bit slower today, which to be fair, we've done 3 days. I'm only doing about 15 minutes at a time, but we've done 3 days worth of work. He's getting better at hustling around the backside of the barrel and getting more comfortable picking up the correct canter lead. I'm obviously not gonna try and do anything very competitive at the rodeo, given like it's my first, it is my first rodeo competing in anyways, and probably his as well. We're not gonna try and go in really quick and do whatever, especially since he's not super conditioned to this yet. So we're just gonna go in and do like a nice little cruise. We might even start off at a trot or break down into trot halfway through, whatever we need, just to make sure he's confident. And of course he'll be in a new environment. He's always a little extra speedy in new environments. Here you go, buddy. So that's our progress so far.
Thursday we had to skip practice because it was raining. And also I did want to give him a day off. This is tough on their bodies. And suddenly it's Saturday, time for the rodeo. Gus traveled really well. He also settled in really quickly. I thought it was funny. We've got our big red rescue trailer and everybody else is in aluminum 3-4 horse trailers because they know what they're doing and we don't. We're just here for the fun of it. Gus handled great in the warm-up pen. We did a lot of canter work to the right to make sure we could get that correct lead going into the arena for our run. We don't even have the correct tack. I don't have a proper barrel saddle or pad or even a breast collar that fits him, because the ones I do have are for full-size horses, not a little 13-hand pony. But we're just gonna try our best and see what we can do. The group that put on this rodeo has a membership, which I am obviously not a part of. Members get priority when it comes to your draw. So we ended up in the Slack after the performance, which ended up being better. I was happy for us not having the extra pressure of trying to perform for a crowd, knowing that we probably wouldn't do very well and we would maybe have to trot some or all of the way, just to make sure that Gus was comfortable with all these kinds of new things that he had to deal with. And poor Gus unfortunately had to stand next to the trailer for about 3 hours while the rodeo went on. So here we are at 10 p.m. practicing again before the Slack. We're waiting in the back of the alleyway here for our turn with all the other riders that are riding in the Slack.
I'm gonna make sure
all my equipment is tight so we can be as safe as possible.
Can you help us get in? Just help us get in? Yeah. Good boy. Buddy, you gotta get out of here. He couldn't find the pattern.
I couldn't see where it was.
Yeah. We were going in and then we got around, and then he's like, where is this? It's like he didn't know where it was.
He couldn't
find the second barrel, and I was like, well, we'll just go to third and practice.
So. It's okay, you're still on, that's all right.
He's a good boy.
I couldn't have been any prouder of this little rescue pony who tried so hard for me given everything new that he was exposed to in this environment. When you look at it through the lens of this is his first time, all of this stuff is new to him, it really doesn't look so bad. We just went in at a trot, we tried to get around a little bit. He got a little lost trying to find that second barrel, whether it was the colors of the barrel or it was blending into the white walls. He was ears forward the whole time, just trying to figure out what I wanted from him. So we made it a positive experience and we learned from it. That's it for this video. Drop us a comment with how you think Gus did at his very first rodeo. Like this video and subscribe if you're not a subscriber already, and we'll see you in the next one.